I have with me today Dean Evans. He's the CMO of Hyundai Motors America. Dean, welcome to the show.
Thank you.
I got to ask you a question. You've been in the business for a while, and I'm sure you've seen some changes. One of the things that I've been, as an analyst and as an anthropologist, studying quite a bit lately is the rapid evolution of customer behavior. And so I'd love to hear from you. What are some of the more profound things that you've observed in the evolution of the customer?
Yeah, no, that's a really good question. Because I think in automotive for years, you know, we held to an old traditional model. You know, a customer comes in, the dealer negotiates with them around price points that, you know, we don't think the customer is aware of, but they are aware of today. And so we're reinventing that at Hyundai and really making sure something like a more transparent price is available to customers today. So it's not like you have to go into the dealership and do a round of negotiations to get to that. It's upfront and posted on our websites. So when consumers, which naturally shop at TrueCar, naturally go to these websites to get an idea of what is a fair price, they can come to us directly today without talking to a dealer and get that price up front.
I gotta imagine that that is not a simple task. The other thing that I'm noticing too in my work is that mobile has fundamentally changed how customers want to first get information and discover, and then also kind of go through the journey in bursts at their own pace, searching for all kinds of things that are very specific. So how does that affect your approach to reaching people in these moments that at any moment could be chaotic at best?
Right. No, I think there's two elements to that. I think there's the first element of how are we getting good at understanding in-market buying intent, because we need to spend more and more of our media dollars putting our value proposition in front of people that are shopping. And so as that gets better and our audience identification gets better, we get better at finding them. And then we have a product called Shopper Assurance, which is this better retail experience, which is better transaction prices up front, a better test drive, a more seamless, fast experience, and a money-back guarantee. So when we're now having that kind of retail betterment message in front of people that are only shopping cars, we think there's a lot of magic there. There's a lot of magic there because most other brands, when they find an in-market audience, they right away want to say, look at my car, look at the feature, or look at the rebate or the low price. We're trying to walk away from that and bring in, at that point, a better retail experience as the value proposition versus a lower price or a bigger rebate when we find those in-market audiences. So we've ushered in, you know, e-commerce layers to all of our dealer websites so consumers can do more of the pre-shopping up front. They can see what their credit is. They can understand lease and buy payments. So they can do what was traditionally taking them hours in the showroom with a salesperson. Now they can come into the showroom, have all of that kind of packaged for them, and they can get right to what we think is the most important part of the dealership experience, the test drive.
The Shopper Assurance program is fantastic because it's truly customer-centered, and I also heard money-back guarantee, which is, that's kind of unprecedented in the auto industry. Having been a consumer for many years, I could maybe count on a few fingers how many great experiences I've had in my entire life, but I wish I was young again. I wish I was going through these experiences again. And what I'd love to hear too is how you were able to convince executives of these new types of programs that basically go against probably what they've done throughout their entire career.
Very good question. You know, some of the ways that we basically convinced stakeholders in this process was from the customer surveying. I mean, we brought everyone to the altar and said, look, we don't have anything to lose. We are merging what we think is the best, which is human beings and salespeople. We don't think in the short term or midterm they can be replaced. And you have technology tools today that kind of help the customer along the way, and the brand that can bridge those best, in our opinion, wins. So that's really how we sold that in. And then the second part to that is once we launched in these pilot markets, we quickly surveyed customers after the fact and said, was this a better automotive retail buying experience than you've had before? And we're getting scores of 75% plus saying it's the best experience they've ever had. And the majority of those consumers are conquested consumers. And What we're finding very enriching about the data is we have now consumers that are picking experiences over make and models, which to us is the best competitive advantage possible, because cars are very similar in quality today. The features and technology are very similar. So what are those differentiators today if the cars are all very similar? And it's the retail experience. But it's also one of those things that takes a long time and a company like that to convince shareholders and stakeholders it's something you need to do. So it's a long answer, I guess, of saying customers and customer data is really what's helped push this whole idea through the system.
You once said that marketing is now the revenue department or something along those lines. And you've also mentioned the importance of experience. In fact, in some of my research, I found that for similar products, customers will pay upwards of 25% more for a product if they know they're going to get a better experience throughout the journey and the life cycle. So I'd love to hear how you bring those two worlds together, and where marketing delivers great customer experience, but it's also now a driver for business growth. And how are you getting there?
Yeah, I've been saying for a while now, you know, chief marketing officers are really chief revenue officers today, because marketing has went from just kind of this creative exercise and crossing your fingers to it's all really data driven today. It's all performance based, you know, a click equals a ratio to a lead to a sale. And so all of that is now full circle. And so we really try to lean in on that with our corporate parent in Korea, with dealers, you know, all those stakeholders, to remind them, including the CFO in the company, that says, look, the more money you put in, the more sales you get out. And it's within these parameters. And it's not like the old days where you threw the TV spot out there, half the time you didn't know it worked, half the time you think it did. That made CFOs nervous. Today, there's a lot less guessing. And so when there's a lot less guessing, in our opinion, then you are the revenue chief at the end of the day. In auto, it used to be the sales chief was the revenue generator. But what we're finding today is you can affect conversion at retail by getting your retailers to close those leads better, and that's important. But it takes the marketing department to get the person in the dealership to begin with. And how many of those prospects do you want in? I.e., we're the revenue generators of the company.
You're also the experience architects of the company as well, because not only are you generating greater sales, but people are walking away happier. Dean, it was such a pleasure to have you on the show, and I hope there's a lot that people could learn from you.
Oh, thank you. It's been a pleasure.